and welcome to another Task Middle-Earth Building Middle-Earth video. In this, we're going to look at continuing our Minas Tirith structure type series. We're going to look at building a Minas Tirith tower. This one has a slight dome roof. The one we'll look at is probably going to have a more tile triangular roof. This is made for foam, pretty much like the other one, but it is quite intricate with all this sort of detail. So we're going for, you know, an intermediate. Don't try this as your first project. Go for the building before. Once you've built a few of those in your confidence, try this out. So what we're going to do, you can see I've already got a bit of work done here. This is because there's only so much time you can see me cut foam out and draw a brickwork pattern in and roll the stone over. So I thought we'd sort of really quickly skip over the basics of this, just get to nitty gritty, which is the actual tower bits that are specific to the tower itself. Now for these, they are 12 inches long and they are 2.5 inches wide. Now the construction of these is going to be, so one bit will go behind like that as normal, then on the other side it's going to go at the front here like this. So just for this is for strength purposes. Now what you're then going to want to do is measure down, I'm going to have to remember I did write this all down but I've lost my sheet. Measure down 2.5 inches from the top and draw a line, and then measure 6 inches from the bottom and draw a line. This will help you place the windows. You can have a small window and a big window. Now what I didn't do on this, which I should have done, is because of the way I'm constructing it, again remember that's going behind and that's going next to, I should have offset the windows by 1/4 inch away from this edge. I should have offset it from this edge. See, I finished one here where I've got it, so then these bits here are equal, whereas now they're just going to be ever so slightly. I'll show you here. You can see that I should have moved it over 1/4 inch towards that way, so this way is only 1/4 inch, that was 3/4 inch, so then it'd have been 1/2 inch, but I forgot. But I've seen medieval buildings that have off-center windows. So you do that. The windows themselves are using the window template we made in the Minas Tirith building, so that's about 1 inch wide, 1.5 inches high, with a little curvature, and you use that to mark out and cut out your window here. And this, the bigger window, is actually the door section for the Minas Tirith building, so that's slightly bigger, so that's going to be about 2 inches, 2.25 inches high, and it's going to be 1.5 inches wide, and again with a circle. But more details of that in the Minas Tirith building, and you just use that to cut out the windows. Then on the back you just stick some cards using the template, again this is all in the Minas Tirith building, and you cut out some sort of arched windows here. And one thing to note is where on the section where you're putting this behind, you need to leave 1/4 inch gap here, so don't make this too big, so then this can glue into here. So, and then go through the brickwork pattern as normal, drawing in archway details and rough it up. Again, all quite standard. Just want to quickly cover that so we can get onto the main bit. Now on here, this is the doorway. I've gone for a big, massive arch doorway, so it's going to end up looking like this. To do this, you're going to measure in 1/2 inch here, and then you're going to measure along till you have 1/4 inch here. Now what this will give you is a section that is 1.75 inches wide, and its height needs to be 4.5 inches, and then you sort of come down about 1.25 inches to here, and then you just sort of draw an angular arch, and then all you do is just going to cut this out. And then what you can do, if you're making multiples of these, keep this section that you cut out by somewhere, and you can use this as a template. So I'm going to cut this out. So there's that. Now next, we're gonna have a back bit, which is gonna be like the same as this, but a quarter of an inch small around the edges. So, and then just get an off, if you've got a peat off cut, just use a bit of that, because then this will stick on like this. Again, when you come to stick this on, you're gonna wanna leave a quarter of an inch gap here. This is very important, because this is where this will be gluing up against. So we have that, and again, you've got the I've marked it out here, and once you cut this out, you can use this template for future ones. But yeah, it's about a quarter of an inch less than the one we've just cut out around the edges, so it'll probably be about an inch and a quarter wide and about 4 inches tall. Again, so I'm going to cut this out now, and we'll come back when I've done that. So there you go, so I've got it cut out, and this will just sit here, and this will get placed here, so then you have something like that, so you can see the stepped effect. And we're just going to fill this in now. Now for that, you want another just off cut. You just want to place it on here like so. And then what you want to do is kind of measure in, just roughly for now, measure in a quarter of an inch again, and then you're going to make this 2 inches high, and this is going to be the door. Now all we're going to do for this door is we're just going to draw it in, so come in. I'm going to place a door here because I don't think the doors we used before will work. So you can see that there is our door. Now you're going to want to cut this bit out. It's like a foam section, this. So you're going to cut that out, and then we're going to get another bit of foam that we stick behind and which we'll draw planks on. So I'm going to cut this out now. Got this bit cut out. Now, let's have a look, where are we? You've got this top bit, that will go on top of that. That will go on top of that. So yeah, it's a nice effect there. But now we need to do the door. For this, I'm gonna get a bit of foam, like so. Now what we're gonna do is just put it in and draw around it. Give us our door like so, and to come down I'm just going to add a planking pattern into it. Now I promise you will watch me do patterns in foam again, but ho hum. And there we go, so we got that, stick that to there like so, that to there, and stick that over the top, which is what I shall do now off camera. And that is the doorway built, and there it is, glued in place. I'm gonna let it go off a bit, and I'm gonna just work the glue in a bit. I forgot I put loads of glue in here, not to worry, that will just act as a sealant. Yeah, you're gonna want to let this dry so it doesn't move around, squidge around before we carry on. And what we're going to be doing next is actually gluing all the walls together. But before we do that, like the Minas Tirith building, once this is dry, you just want to paint the inside black, because this will just be, when you put it together, you don't want to see the pink through the window holes. So let this dry, paint it black, and we'll come back to glue it all together. Got undercoated in the back, on the underneath, so we're now ready to glue them. This is actually quite tricky, so I'm going to put a block. I'm going to start with this, which is the doorway. It's going to be the easiest piece to do. What you can do is on this section here, where we've made the doorway, you can put some glue here to rest it upon. Do this. You want to work believe it's dry for a bit before doing the rest, but not so much you can't make any adjustments if you need to adjust it. So you're going to put that there. Bring it up there. And then the next bit, as that gets glued on top, the next bit gets glued to the side. So on this, I'm going to run some glue down here. Like so. Put this to the side here. Like so. And then this bit, put here. So what you want to do on this, put a bit of glue along the back bit here and a bit of glue along the side. So here's the glue on the back and glue on the side here. Done off camera, brilliant. And then we're just gonna pop it on here, and then it's a case of fiddling around with it until it's all in position and holding it while it dries for a bit. Not long, just enough time. Fiddle around, faff around until it's all where it needs to be. Glue it, and I'll do that off camera. In fact, this looks like it's not going to be too bad. The one I made before this was a nightmare. I think this one's going to be alright. I shall do that off camera and leave this to dry, probably overnight. If you are having difficulty getting it all to stay in place, what you can do is you can do what we've done in previous buildings where you pin it. The only problem is you don't really want the pins on the top half here, as they'll show, but on this bit here it won't be too bad because we're going to be doing putting some buttresses on. So you can pins here on these bits here just to help hold it in place, which will make life a lot easier. So I can do one couple here like this, like so. We can put one inside here. Always have pins handy when you're doing foam, especially if you know you can hide where the pins go in. And there is such a small gap, but really, if you did want to put it where this board won't matter too much. You can end up with, can't even see them now. There is a pinhole like that, so it's up to you. It will just hold it in place better. There we go. Here's not too bad on this side. I put a pin, but here, this will be quite difficult to do. Here, you won't be able to put a pin at the bottom here because it's just going to go through. So what we can do is put on about halfway up, about here, just to really hold it in place. There you go. Now we've got to worry about this top section, but being you've got pins in holding it quite tight, it should hold nicely. Yeah, like that. So there we go. That's just a little tip for this stage. It can get quite annoying and quite fiddly. There we go. We've got some pins in. We can leave the rest dry now. Just be able to work it. Now I'll leave it dry. All dry now, and looks good. Next, we're going to make the buttresses. Now these are going to go on each corner here. To make these, you're going to need some strips of foam. You're going to need eight that are 8.5 inches long, and they're going to be, you have one that's 3/4 inch wide, four that are 3/4 inch wide, and four that are 1/2 inch wide. So in total you have eight of those. Then you're going to need eight that are 5 inches long, and again four of those are 3/4 inch, and four of them are 1/2 inch. Then at the end, one end, come down 1/2 inch and then sort of mark it across, so you go across diagonally to the top. And then I'm using a hot wire cutter here just to cut it off at an angle. You can do this with a knife, but the cut looks better with a hot wire cutter. So if you do have access to one, use one like that. And that's it. Once you've got these prepared, we're going to glue them on. Now, the reason they're different lengths is because of the way you constructed the building. So here on this side, it's quarter of an inch. Half an inch, and here it's going to be 3/4. So what we're going to do is this, the half inch one will be stuck here, and the 3/4 one will be stuck here, and then when it rotates round, you have the half inch one coming in here, like so, like that. So what I'll do is fine. Start to glue these in place, and I'll come back when I've glued these in. Here we are with the first lot done, tool lot done. So then, now don't worry about how it doesn't match up at the top on these bits here. We're going to cut those down once it's dry. Next, we're going to do exactly the same, except we're going to do it with the smaller pieces. So, going to come in. So on this back bit here, you're going to put a short bit there, and your long bit's going to come here and overhang, like we've done on this side, and then short bit is going to go here, and then you'd have a long bit overhanging here. So I'm going to let these long bits dry a bit first, and then I'm going to stick the shorter bits on. The kind of final jobs now is the top sort of roof bit of it, and for this we're going to use a piece of foam that's 3 inches by 3 inches, then 2 triangles that are 3 inches up the bottom, and then the sort of peak of it is just 2 inches high. For that, then we're going to get a piece of card that again is 3 inches wide and 5 inches long, and then just score it down the middle and fold it in half, and this will act as our roof. Ooh, I'm going to get out of focus in. It's going to sit like that, and then just like normal, I've gone through and made a load of pre-cut tiles. We've seen this done before, so that bit's not the exciting bit, and the ridge tile, it's this bit here we're going to concentrate on. So we're going to glue these little bits onto here and then glue the roof on. So I'm running out of glue, so I may be doing this off camera. I've got some more on order. There will be a link in the description to this glue, because it's a really cool glue. It's even though it's PVA, it dries really quick and really solid, which is just what you want if you don't like me, you don't like using a hot glue gun. I have one, he's posted in a few videos. I just don't want to use it. Glue that in. I think I'm desperately running out of glue. I've run all that. I said, if you want to buy this glue, there is a link in the description, and you can get it from Amazon. I get a little kickback from it, so it doesn't cost you anything. You get a product and support the channel, which is nice. Rather nice, as I don't really want to do Patreon and all that. I'm waffling on. It's going to be rather difficult. I've not really thought this through, have I? Kind of wanted to glue that first. But anyway. There we go, that's how I want it. Like so. Feel a little tent almost. I'm gonna let that dry, and then I'm just gonna, I won't do it on camera because you've seen it done before, put the tiles on. We'll come back when that's done. So the roof's on. top bits on, you can see like that. Just got one final bit to do now, and that's on the buttresses. You'll see where we've glued these together. You've got these overhangs. What you're going to want to do with this is come down and carefully with a knife cut them away like so. Angle it off like that, so you have them like this rather than this overhang. And that's it. All you've got to do now is paint it. I'm not going to cover the paint in this video because it's been done in the Minas Tirith building. It's just black and in various greys, and it'll end up like this. Paint the door brown. It's all covered in the Minas Tirith video. And you can also do sort of alternatives. For this one, I wanted to go for a domed roof, so I used a polystyrene ball, but the ball I used was for a different upcoming video a few weeks' time, so it's a bit too big, so I figured if I can just shave it down a bit, it might fit on. But in the end, it was the dome wasn't as steep as I liked, but it still looks good. So you can have domed roofs and triangular roofs like this. So let's have a look at both of these set up on the board. Thanks for watching, we hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit the like button and leave a comment. If you haven't already, please subscribe. Stick with the channel for many great videos to come.